Awoke up this morning when the man
said, freedom. Malcolm X had a far-reaching effect on the civil rights movement. In the South, there had been a long tradition of self-reliance. Malcolm X's ideas now touched that tradition. In 1965, the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee launched new strategies to challenge white control of Southern politics.
Our direction was clear: a heavy emphasis on nationalism. Strong as Malcolm had it, as strong as we could get it.
Carmichael and other SNCC members began a voter drive in Loundes County, Alabama, known as Bloody Loundes for its violence against blacks. Although 80% of the population was black, there were no black elected officials. Economically dependent on white plantation owners, many were afraid to join civil rights efforts, and none had been allowed to register to vote until early 1965.
Now in this country it says majority rules. We are 80% of the majority in this, we are 80% in this county, and we have the right to rule this county. We have the right to rule this county, and we're going to rule it. I don't care how poor we are and how black we are, we're going to govern this county.
Stokely Carmichael and Colton Cox and others who got together and told us, according to the Alabama law, if we didn't like what the Democratic Party was doing in our county or the Republican Party, we could form our own political organization and it could become a political party.
George Wallace was in the head of the Alabama Democratic Party. The Alabama Democratic Party was racist. Its symbol at that time had a white rooster, and it had the words of white supremacy. That was the official emblem of the Democratic Party of Alabama. So here it would be easy for us to tell our people, hey, look, this party is not for us. We need our own party.
The new political party was named the Loundes County Freedom Organization, but it became better known by the symbol it chose, a Black Panther.
And then when we chose that symbol as a Black Panther, then many of the people in our county stopped saying we were violent during that time. You know, now you got a violent group in Loundes County who has turned out, who's going to start killing black white folks. But it wasn't that. It was a political, just a symbol to our organization that we was here to stay and we were going to do whatever needed to be done to survive.
Everybody was excited because they said, well, they have the rooster, which represents the Democratic Party, the elephant, which represents the Republican Party. Why can't we have a black cat to represent us? Everybody knows how a cat looked, and we were excited because we knew that if a person couldn't read and write, they sure knew the difference between a cat, an elephant, and a rooster.
SNCC went door to door and farm to farm, explaining to first-time voters the rules for taking part in the Loundes County primary.
Now, the law says that you can't vote in ours and also vote in the Democratic primary, which has to be held on the same day, according to the law. Mm-hmm. So that what we'll have to do is vote on one and not the other. So if you want to vote for our candidates, for sheriff, for tax assessor, tax collector, coroner, and the school board, then you have to vote for us.
On May 3rd, 1966, Loundes County blacks voted for the first time since the end of Reconstruction. Some voted as Democrats in the Haynesville courthouse. Several blocks away, the Loundes County Freedom Organization held its primary on the grounds of the First Baptist Church. Voters for the Independent Party were introduced to candidates for seven offices, including sheriff, before casting their ballots. Even with the ever-present threat of violence, 900 black voters showed up that day to vote for the Panther.
This was the first time that the black people in this county had came together to make choice of their own candidates for public office. It was important also because of the numbers of people that turned out to that election on that day and voted for their candidates and felt that they had done something for themselves to start making changes, the kind of changes they wanted to see happen in the system.
11 days later, Stokely Carmichael, representing the new militancy within SNCC, defeated John Lewis as national chairman.